मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर फाइन, कीपिंग वेल इन दिस कोल्ड विंटर सीजन. टेक केयर एंड बी इनसाइड एट होम एंड स्टडी ऑल्सो. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू चैप्टर ऑफ हिस्ट्री. वी हैव डन चैप्टर 7 ऑलरेडी. ओके, नाउ वी हैव नेक्स्ट चैप्टर इज चैप्टर 8. एज यू कैन सी इट इन द बोर्ड, the name is the first empire. Previous classes we have seen that man used to live in caves and forest. He got an idea of agriculture, so he started living where? He started living on making huts, villages came, and then Janpadas and Mahajanpadas we learned in the previous chapter 6. The biggest and the most famous Mahajanpada was Magadha. We learned there were 4 Mahajanpadas which were very famous, and Magadha was very very famous and the largest Mahajanpada. Okay, so now we are going to learn the first empire. Okay, so the first heading we have in the book, the prevailing situation. So first we will take the book in our hand and see the paragraph and understand it. The prevailing situation. By around 323 BCE before Common Era, Magadha, as I told you, the biggest Mahajanpada, the major Indian kingdom of that time, was ruled by a king who was unpopular among the people. We had learnt about the previous chapter in 6 about Mahajanpada, and during the 323, the king who was ruling in Mahajanpada of Magadha was very unpopular. People was not loving him. The people of Magadha were not happy with his rule, as he was not caring towards the people. Okay, the kingdom had spread over a vast area, but the rulers were gradually losing control. Magadha was such a big empire of Bihar, Bengal, and all that area under it. But what happened? Slowly, slowly, the empire was losing all its effect, control of people. People did not have any faith now in the king, those who were ruling. Other smaller states also wanted to be free from the rule of Magadhan Empire. Foreign invaders from outside attacks also were there. Lot of invaders means attack. Overrun large sections of the country. They also controlled large portion of the country. Alexander, a very ambitious Greek king, was processing towards India. So that time, during 323, when Magadha Empire was losing all its effect, people were not having faith into the kings and the rulers. At that time only, Alexander invaded India. Akraman kar diya usne. Okay. Now, Alexander's efforts to conquer India. What are the things Alexander did? Okay. So first paragraph is clear to you. We have learned in first paragraph that during 323 before Common Era, the Magadhan Empire was not ruled by a proper king. People had no faith into them, and the empire, which was very large, losing its effect, and many other attacks were there. So at that time, Alexander also attacked. Okay, now Alexander entered India through Hindu Kush Mountains. Now, Hindu Kush Mountains, don't think is Himalaya Mountain. In your book, you have a map. Can you see in the book? There is a map here. Okay? Here, they have shown you Hindu Kush Mountain. See, after Pakistan, Afghanistan, and in Afghanistan, there is Hindu Kush Mountain shown. Here. Can you see with the green color? Okay, after Pakistan, Afghanistan, then Hindu Kush Mountain. I have put my finger just near that. All right. So he crossed Hindu Kush mountain, Afghanistan, Pakistan, crossed Indus River, okay, and came into India. So there was no trains and buses and all, people used to travel on foot. So he came to India by crossing Hindu Kush mountains. He fought his way through by 326 BCE. He had crossed Indus River and here he met the king of Takshila. So he crossed mountains, he crossed River Indus, and then he met the king of Takshila, which is located near Islamabad, the capital of Pakistan. Okay? Now what happened? The king. Now the king was, 1 minute children. Now the king was welcomed by, the king welcomed Alexander and extended his generous hospitality to Alexander as well. So the king of Takshila welcomed who? Alexander. He gave all facility to Alexander as an army, gave him mehman nawazi ki unki, okay? And he also provided to Alexander, the king of Takshila, 5,000 troops. Troops means sipahi or army, 5,000, okay? To help Alexander in his future conquest. Conquest means wherever he is going for war, he should win. For that, the king of Takshila helped Alexander, gave him all kinds of support and hospitality, and then gave him 5,000 troops also. Okay, notably against King Porus. Why he was giving all the support to Alexander? Because he wanted to destroy his neighbor, and the neighbor was King Porus. Okay, now this is like a story, so it's very interesting. You must have seen nowadays TV channels provide Chandragupta serial was there, Porus was also one serial coming, all historical. Then you had Sikandar Mahan also one serial. So this all tells you some, the much things are in fiction, but some part of history also you get there. Okay, so King of Takshila helped Sikandar, gave him all kinds of support, gave him 5,000 troops, notably, most probably, so that he could defeat his neighbor. The name was King Porus. Alexander confronted 2,000 strong elephant army of King Porus and was successful in defeating him. So successful he was because Alexander fought with Porus. Porus had 200,000 strong elephant army, but Porus fought bravely and then he was defeated. He, however, re-insisted him and made him his ally. Okay, so they both became allies. Okay, his army had, so King Porus was defeated and Alexander defeated 2,000 strong army of King Porus. Okay, this much we have. Then what happened? Look at the book on page number 61, first paragraph. His army reached near present day Lahore when for the first time his soldiers refused to obey him. Now Alexander had set on a very, very large conquest. He wanted to conquer whole world. Okay? Now, so his army used to fight continuous war, but first time when they reached near the Lahore, they were tired and they refused to fight anymore. So they refused first time to Sikandar, Alexander, and they were exhausted, very tired of fighting, and they were also missing their family because they were way out from their homes for many, many months. Okay, so Alexander left the occupied territories on on the west of the Indus River under the control of his general, that is Seleucus Nicator. So he returned back. Instead of coming inside India, he thought of going back. So he took his armies and whatever he had occupied, the areas, okay, those areas, those territories, he gave to his one of his general and said, you look after all these territories. The name of the general was Seleucus Nicator, and returned to Greece. So he went back to Greece, Alexander, and all the part that he had conquered, all those areas, he gave to one of his general. The name of the general is Seleucus Nicator. Now in 323 BCE, Alexander died at Babylon. On the way back to Greece only he died. Okay. Now the exile, the exit of Alexander and the gradual decline of Magadha led to the breaking of territories held by them. Now Alexander has gone, and the Mauryan Empire, the Magadhan Empire, full Magadha and Janpada, Mahajanpada, was becoming or breaking into smaller territories. Okay, there was no proper ruler at that time. So during this chaotic period, chaotic means so much of situation is not peaceful. Wars are going on. Magadha Empire is breaking into smaller pieces. Okay, smaller pieces. All the smaller states are become free. The rulers are not ruling properly. People were not happy with the rulers. And over that, the attack of Alexander. Alright, so that is a chaotic period. Okay, now a new leader called Chandragupta Maurya emerged in Magadhan Empire. He became the founder of Mauryan Empire. The Mauryan Empire. Understood? The first empire is Mauryan Empire. So we have learned these two headings. I have told you Alexander's effort to conquer India. He couldn't do that because his soldiers or his army refused to do. So he went back to Greece. On the way, in Babylon only he died. And whatever territories he conquered, till Islamabad, or we say till Lahore, those territories he gave to his general to look after, and the Magadhan Empire also had no proper ruler. At that time, a new ruler came in Magadhan Empire, and his name was Chandragupta Maurya. Now we are going to learn about the Mauryan Empire. Now, Chanakya was a very well-learned man, a teacher, okay, known as Kautilya. His name is also Kautilya, Chanakya. His name is Kautilya, but he was called as Chanakya. He was a teacher. In Takshila, when Alexander came to west to annex the surrounding territories, so he was a teacher in Takshila, okay, and that time Alexander wanted to conquer Takshila, west territories of India. Okay, the king of Takshila and Gandhara became allies to Alexander. So the kings of Takshila, okay, and Gandhara, they were not ready to fight. Okay, they gave up already. Har maan gaye pehle, and they were ready to join the hands with Alexander. Chanakya, however, planned to defeat Alexander. So, but Chanakya had a plan that we can defeat Alexander, and he wanted to. He sought help. Sought help means उन्होंने मदद मांगी, मदद ढूंढी from other kings to unite and fight with Alexander. So he said, Gandhara's king, Takshila king, they all are surrendering, are ready to join the hands with Alexander, but we can fight with him. So he asked all the kings to join together and fight with Alexander. But he was defeated at the Battle of Hai. Now Porus, as I told you in the previous paragraph when we were learning about the Alexander, okay, up, so he was ready to fight. Was the only king who challenged Alexander, but he was defeated at the battle of Hypas river known as Jhelum. So as we have learned already in the paragraph that Porus was defeated, okay, but he did not give up without fighting. So he fought but he lost. Chanakya then further east to Magadha. So he moved. Now Chanakya thought, let me take help from east, okay, of Magadha. So he went to Dhanananda. Now that time Dhanananda was the ruler of Magadha, who was ruling the Nanda Empire, which is extended from Bihar and Bengal in the east of Punjab and Sindh. So Magadhan Empire was at that time ruled by Dhanananda. But Dhanananda refused to help him. This incident, Chanakya persuaded his disciple. So we have seen, if you see, there was previously one year, two, three years back, a serial used to come, Chandranandini. If you had historical serial, if you watch, you get some idea. In that they had shown also that Chanakya goes to ask help from Dhanananda, that let us unite together and fight with Alexander. But he insulted Chanakya and was not ready to help and listen to him. So Chandragupta trained his disciple. Who was the disciple of Chanakya? Chandragupta Maurya. Okay, now Chandragupta at the age of only 20 finally overthrew King Dhanananda. So only at a very young age of 20 years, Chandragupta defeated Dhanananda and took over the empire of Magadha with the guidance and all support of Chanakya. Thus it was in 321 BCE that Chandragupta Maurya, under the patronage, help of genius, all the plans, how to do, when to do, under the guidance of Chanakya, became the ruler of Magadha. He started Mauryan dynasty. Understood about this one, the Mauryan Empire? Mauryan Empire, we know Alexander wanted to invade more part of him, wanted to come into India. All the other kings of Takshila and Gandhara surrendered and joined hands with it. Only Porus was the king who confronted, but lost or was defeated. So Chanakya wanted to get support from the east of Magadha, where the king was at that time. Dhanananda, he refused to do so. So Chanakya trained one of his disciples, that was Chandragupta, with the guidance and help of Chanakya, defeated Dhanananda and became the ruler of Mauryan, obviously Magadha, and thus started a new empire, first empire, Mauryan Empire. Okay, so this is for today, children. Three readings only I have taught you. Very simple story time. Read it, okay, and then you will understand it better. We will meet in the next class and discuss more about the Mauryan Empire. Thank you and have a very, very good day. Bye.